Dominic, do the Texans need to trade Watson ASAP?
First of all, nice job jumping in there and saving your two friends because they were getting dominated. But as for Deshaun Watson, I do think that they need to trade him because he seems serious about this, and it seems like it's irreconcilable. The way that he's talking about it. He's been patient, and it seems to me that the news that's going to come out is going to make this seem a little bit worse than it's been so far. And I understand that you have the leverage to force him to stay. You don't have to trade him, so that's fine. But you know what can undercut everything that's going on in your organization? If the best player on your team, the leader of your locker room, shows up in a bad mood and doesn't like you and is not happy to be there, does not believe in the general manager, the coach, or the people or the family that owns the team. So to me, it seems like you should have thought, if you wanted to keep him, you should have thought about this years ago when you wasted some of his prime years. So like it feels like it's too late. You need to get what you can and let him move on and be great elsewhere, and hopefully what you bring back is something that you can build upon.
I don't think they have to do anything right now. I think that with Deshaun Watson, I think the team has an opportunity, a window right now, to try to sell Deshaun Watson on a vision. Nick Caserio, who's the GM, you know, obviously came from New England and partnered with Bill Belichick, has built the greatest dynasty that you know we've seen in league history. So I think right now, with all the things that's going on, and Dominique, you know this as well, we probably only heard 10% of what's really going on behind the scenes. But I think they still have a window, an opportunity to sell Deshaun Watson. Listen, this is what we're trying to do. And I think for the Houston Texans' sake, I think the owner just got to step out of the way. Because clearly what Deshaun Watson is so upset about is primarily with ownership. And I think it's going to be incumbent on Nick Caserio to really lay it out to Deshaun Watson, hey, This is what I'm trying to do. This is what I'm trying to build here. I want to collaborate with you on that, front office quarterback, kind of relationship to build the Houston Texans into a long-term winner down here. They don't have to make the move now, but time is of the essence.
Yeah, I think Damian's right in that Nick Caserio has an opportunity to say, listen, I'm new here. Whatever was happening before, that's not on me, but this is what we are going to be. This is what the Houston Texans under my leadership will be like. Now, whether Deshaun Watson will buy that, who knows? But if I'm the Texans, to me, the only sure thing in this franchise was Deshaun Watson. All you had to do was keep him. All you had to do was make him happy, because he was the one sure thing when you look at this roster and you look at the leadership it's had. I don't think this relationship can be salvaged, I'll be honest. It's almost like a couple is living separately. Like, they've already, it's like, yes, could they reconcile? Sure, but she done took her stuff and moved away. She's in a different residence, and you're trying to reach her, and she's not answering her phone. Now it's like, I don't know what she's thinking. I hope is she going to come back when OTAs kick off? Like, will Deshaun be on the field? I don't know. I guess I'll just wait and see. Like, that is not a good situation you want to have if you're trying to hit reset. And if Deshaun is not happy and there's a way that you can send him somewhere where he is free and you get some draft picks, I think it's a win-win.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.